SeaJay, your favorite scuba diver here with Deep South Divers. Today's job is to do a ship's hull inspection in preparation for a survey. This boat is for sale. You can see what a gorgeous area this is. Shelter Cove on Hilton Head Island. Alright. We're going to start on the starboard side. This is a trim tab. Checking for damage, paint condition, hull condition. That right there is a starboard side rudder. You can see it's nice and clean. And the starboard side prop has got all of its barnacles recently knocked off. The other diver left a lot of barnacle bases on there, but she's going to be traveling to Florida, and those barnacle bases will wear off on the trip. So I'm not too concerned about that. But here, that is a keel on the bottom of the shaft housing. She's actually got two of these, one for each prop. Sort of a unique design, very strong. And you can see the condition of the paint is excellent. More of that housing. And I found this intake along the way. There's a few barnacles here and there, but no restrictions. That could be a raw water intake for flushing toilets or for a generator. But I'll look at her whole hull here, looking for blisters anywhere in the paint. And that right there is a stabilizer. She has two, one on each side. That's the starboard side stabilizer. I'm looking up and into her moving parts and making sure that everything's nice and clean. You can see the paint is in excellent condition. No blisters anywhere, literally perfect paint. She's a gorgeous boat anyway, but underwater she's really pretty. That right there is the keel, the main center line of the boat. And we worked our way forward to the bow thruster. It spins freely. And you can see that when one prop spins, the one on the opposite side spins in the opposite direction. Along the bow here, we'll check the water line. And that pretty paint continues right along the waterline. Real pretty, real smooth, really clean. We'll move over to the bow thruster again. This is the port side now. And in the center, there's supposed to be a zinc, a little button zinc, they call it. That's missing, but that's easy to replace. The next time she's dived and cleaned, the diver should put a button zinc on that. Props move real smooth, nice and clean on the outside, and that right there is a port side stabilizer. All the moving parts are nice and clean, barnacle free. That stuff on there, that dust, we call either dust or biofilm. That'll all get knocked off on her trip down to Florida. It'll just kind of wipe off. The important part is that the hard growth is minimal. The paint is in excellent condition. And I'm really looking for big damage. And I see none. She's in great shape. That right there is an engine intake. That's a huge engine intake, one on either side, no restrictions, a couple of barnacles here and there, not really a big deal. The important part is that water can flow, and let's check the other side. This is back to the starboard side. That's a little muddier, but still plenty of flow up into those engines so that they'll stay cool. Those engine intakes are often damaged when a sling picks them up, and those are not. Those are in excellent condition. So this right here is that port side shaft housing. It's sort of a big keel and shaft housing in one. I'm looking for damage, looking for dents, dings. There's a few barnacle bases, but there's no damage, no dents, no dings. Let's look at the cutlass bearing up here and each one of the blades. I probably would have wanted these props to be a little bit cleaner. All the bases are still on there. But the props spin freely. No damage along the edges. And I'll inspect each individual blade for any dings, dents. Anything that hints that it's ever struck anything hard. It's very common in the low country to find damage to these props or these wheels, whatever you want to call them. And I'm sort of shaking the prop back and forth to make sure that it's tight on its shaft, and it is. No damage, no dents, no dings. The cutlass bearing there can flow water just fine, so I know those cutlass bearings are in good shape. Like I said, I'd have wanted those a little bit cleaner, but most of that stuff will just fall off on the way to Florida. All in all, it's fairly clean. A good shake there, make sure that prop is tight. Let's move over to the starboard side. Same thing, a little bit of fuzz here and there, a little bit of barnacles and oysters. But all that'll wear right off. These props are clean enough. And all of the edges are in excellent condition. Yeah, it's very common to see dents and dings along the edges in the low country. That's because we have these huge 8-foot tides, and it's not uncommon for these props to touch bottom occasionally. But these have not. These are in great shape, which is important because these props are large enough to be pretty expensive. I'm going to say probably $30,000 a piece. So having them in great shape is really important. I found an exhaust port. I'm going to look way up in there and see if I see any restrictions, barnacles, oysters. And just like the rest of her painted hull, it's clean, clear, in great shape. That definitely gets a stamp of approval. Back on the port side rudder here. These are skirted rudders. They have kind of a skirt that goes over the top of them. And that increases their effectiveness and makes them work really well. This is a zinc sitting on the back, on the transom they call it, at the stern. So I'm going to move over here and check out this port side trim tab. A little bit of fuzz, but paint's in excellent condition. Take a look in there and see if I see anything wrong with the piston. Nothing wrong with the piston, all in great shape. Move on over to the starboard side here. Let's inspect that as well. No hydraulic fluid, nothing weird. Except, hey, look at that, it's a blue crab. Living inside of that trim tab. I'd stick my hand in there, but he'd probably chop it off. I think that he's got his girlfriend in there too. We'll move forward on the gunwale of the vessel. That's the right side, starboard gunwale, and you can see where this trim tab is jointed to the bottom of the boat. All of that looks great. No damage to the very tips of the keels. There are those exhaust ports again. And let's check the port side trim tab. Nobody living up in there, but I didn't get the opportunity to check forward on the side gunwale there, the port gunwale, aft. Looks great. All of it looks great. I'll go ahead and inspect the seams, make sure the seams are clean. Cutlass bearing can breathe. Yeah, no damage, nothing weird. Paint's in great shape. There's no paint on the running gear, on the prop, shaft, or rudder. But that's normal. That's to be expected. That stuff wears off in a matter of about 6 months. And right there in the center of the transom is a great big giant zinc. Everything is internally bonded. I would give that a big stamp of approval. Thanks for watching. We'll see you on the next video.